Hello and welcome to the Fritz60 tutorial about the new function EasyGain. I think this might be the most enjoyable new thing in Fritz16. You now can play against the computer and have fun with it. Obviously, playing against an engine at full strength is not really fun, but in the EasyGain mode, we tried to mimic a human opponent for you. It means that the engine plays reasonable moves, but it's prone to fall into tactical traps or sometimes just to play weak positional moves. The main point being that you get a chance to beat it while having the experience of playing a realistic game of chess like you would have against a human in your club. So we click on Easy Game to launch this function. And first of all, we would set a strength for our computer opponent. For that, we click on the levels button and we have a choice of 6 levels. Beginner would be too weak for you and grandmaster probably too strong. We will recommend club player, and if you want to have pure fun, you can also try hobby player. Sometimes it's nice to crush your opponent in a straight mating attack. We take club player, which would be a reasonable opponent of something like maybe Elo 1500 to 1800, depending on the type of position. Okay, we start a new game. We can easily choose between white or black. We take white. And we'll have a training game, so we will want to see the live book to play proper theory. So let's do some theoretical moves here. Okay, this is... I play like f4 here. Okay, and I'm looking for ways of attacking on the king side. Because the sharper I play, the more likely that Fritz will find a way to spoil his position tactically. Alright. Queen g3. So this is interesting. Fritz now has played a move which is probably not really theory anymore, because on club player levels it doesn't follow the book moves to an arbitrary depth, but at some depth it just starts calculating on its own. Okay, so we have the choice of taking or e5. I think e5 should be the proper move. Now we probably have knight e4, yeah. And then, yeah, I think we'd have to take this, of course. So. Okay, now I think I have the right type of position against Fritz and Easy Game. There are attacking chances for me. This will be a lively opening game, chances for both sides. And now that would be a good time to think for first time in the game. And this is the proper moment to introduce an important new thing in Fritz16, assisted calculation. We have tried to introduce a function which enables you to train calculating. Calculating is the most important decisive factor for playing strength. The better you calculate, the better you play. And what would be more natural than training calculation in a game you just play? And this is what we're gonna do. So let's activate this function here. First of all, we show the notation of the game, then we click on assisted calculation. And we get some hints in the notation as help text how this function works. Basically, the idea is you enter moves on the board, but those moves are not executed so that you cannot see the arising position. But if you want to see it, you can always do so by right-clicking on the board to unveil it. the point of the function is to train your ability to visualize positions by moving pieces on the board without actually moving them. Okay, I do not have the ambition to calculate the strongest moves here. My task is to show you how this function works. For example, well, let's have a look at this move f5, which somehow I'd like to play in a blitz game. So I click on this move, and if you like, you can get assistance here. You click on the move on the pawn, you hold it down, and you see that this target square, f4 to f5, is marked green. This means this move is quite a good move. It's tactically, it's not only tactically sound, but it's also one of the best moves in the positions. And because, as I said, it's nice to play sharply against the program, it is recommended to find such moves, because then Fritz might find tactical errors for himself. Okay, we play f5. And what would be the first answer which we should reckon with for black? I think that would be taking. So we take. Now I think we should retake the pawn and do so with the knight. But I'd like to check the correctness of this by clicking on the knight. And interesting, this is not the strongest move in this position. There is probably something stronger. And I can find this by getting a hint while moving my mouse wheel. And this marks the c pawn. And the interesting thing that obviously taking on f5 is not strong, because what would happen? I take here. And how does Fritz refute my move? I think the black must take on f5, because otherwise I threaten mate on g7. For example, if I take on c2, it's marked deeply red, which means it's a very bad move. Then I take on g7,
mate.
Yeah, thank you for the hint. I've seen this myself. Thank you very much. Now, first of all, right clicking on the board position shows what we have here. So you visualize the position and you can check whether you see the correct position by right clicking on it. Okay, we see this correctly. And to further correctly calculate this variation, you go back before the blunder, queen c2, and with black you play the move which would be the proper thing to do, which means taking here. And we retake with the rook. And now I think black could take on c2. Okay. And again, to check this position, whether we see it correctly, try this for a second. Try to see the position which is now on the board in this variation. Then you right-click, and you can check whether you see the right position. And the nice thing about it is that you calculate variations which are tactically correct, because Fritz helps you, but you train the essential thing, which means visualize those positions. Normal annotation functions would also work here, while in assisted calculation you could, for example, just right-click, promote this variation, because this is obviously the more interesting mainline. I think that should be enough for now, but let's get back to the game. We do this by again clicking on assisted calculation. This brings us back to our game position, and indeed we now play f5, and Fritz will now answer again, and we follow our game. Now also, we can use this little assistance which we have seen the calculation of course in the game. We click on the piece and we can check, is our intended move, for example knight f5, is it really strong? And since this target square f5 is not really very nicely green, there must be something stronger in the position. And interestingly enough, there is, and we can find this out by pulling our mouse wheel to get a hint. And Fritz suggests that we just do not retake this pawn, but continue with development instead. Pretty interesting. I would take so take on the f5 here. And now it gets really exciting and sharp. And now I really would normally need to calculate. But this video is already running for 10 minutes, and I think I have shown anything which is there is to be known about the easy game functions. I leave with a final remark, saying that after some moves played on your own, Fritz will try to estimate your current playing level, and it has estimated me in this game up to now to play at ELO 1700. Thank you very much for your attention.